Come closer. I want to talk to you. I'm going to tell you an astounding story. The story of the Maltese Falcon. I could tell you a thousand tales of the men and women who have hunted this evil bird. But every story has the same ending. Murder.
In the 1940s, Hollywood movies got dark. Now, these movies were set in the shadows and took place in dark alleyways and twisted cityscapes. Now, these films didn't just look dark, they told dark stories about corrupt people and moral ambiguity. Lasting well into the mid-1950s, these films became known as the genre of film noir. Film noir is a French term, which literally translates into black film. Now, one of the first and best noirs ever made was The Maltese Falcon. John Huston's adaptation of Dashiell Hammett's crime novel not only introduced the world to a then unknown Humphrey Bogart, it also changed how crime films were lit, shot, and executed. In doing so, Maltese Falcon helped create the genre of film noir. How does the film do all this? Well, just give me a few minutes of your time, and let's go back and take a closer look at The Maltese Falcon. Now, Maltese Falcon is a murder mystery centering around Detective Sam Spade as he hunts for a group of criminals who are each searching for an exotic treasure that has taken the form of a statue of a falcon. Now, Hammett's story was first published in a cheap pulp magazine called Black Mask, and these pulp magazines were rough and grainy material that often told violent crime stories. Many of them were the inspiration for early film noirs. Now, in adapting this pulp story, the Maltese Falcon movie has utilized some of the novel's visual style. So in referencing these pulp magazines, film noirs like Maltese Falcon created innovative lighting styles, specifically a lighting style known as low-key lighting. Now, low-key lighting was light that came from only one source. Take a look at these images for examples of low-key lighting. Now, because low-key lighting only came from one source, it was lighting that created shadows. We can see these deliberate uses of shadow and light in several scenes in The Maltese Falcon. So with Maltese Falcon, you're not just seeing a story shot at night. You're seeing a movie that deliberately harnesses the darkness of the world. Now, the movie wasn't just innovative in its visual style. It was also unique in how it portrayed its detective. Humphrey Bogart has immortalized the character of Sam Spade as a cynical, foul-mouthed man who puts himself before anyone else. Now, what's different here is before Maltese Falcon, movie detectives were these caricatures. They were super intelligent people like Charlie Chan. Or they were classy and sophisticated like Nick and Nora Charlton from the Thin Man series. Sam Spade was not like any of these guys. He wasn't some rich sleuth who solved murders in his spare time. He was plain spoken and even vulgar. Also, Spade may be the lead in this story, but he's not the hero. As the story continues, he actually joins forces with the bad guys, one of whom has even killed his partner. So with this character of Sam Spade, we get a reveal of a key theme of Maltese Falcon, which is ambiguity. The mystery is not just who shot Sam Spade's partner, but who and what in this world is real and what is fake. For those who have seen it already, think about how much ambiguity is in this movie. The driving question of the plot is, who killed Sam Spade's partner? But there are so many other questions in this story. Who is this mysterious woman who has entranced Sam Spade? Does she love him, or is she just faking it? Does Sam Spade really love this woman, or is he just faking it? Who are these mysterious people after this exotic bird? And the most important question is, what and where is the Maltese Falcon? And why are so many people ready to kill for it? We see that when all these characters actually seize the Falcon, the one thing in the movie that is supposed to be unambiguous and provide the only answers only raises more questions. And it turns out that a lot more than just Sam Spade's emotions are phony. So I love The Maltese Falcon. I think it's a good example of film noir and a hell of an entertaining murder mystery. So if you don't mind watching old black and white movies or older films, please seek this one out. It's worth your time. Okay, thanks for listening. Please post comments below, share this video, and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.